Hi all, welcome to SQL training session. So in this session we are going to learn how we can implement the logging in SSIS packages. And before starting the session, before creating a project and show you how to implement the logging, first we will understand a little bit a theory part to understand what is basically logging means. Logging is, if we see an English term, the logging means to keep it to keep track of records, what you have done, or to keep the track of the record on every event which has occurred. Okay, you can understand it by taking an example. Suppose if you are working in organization, by end of the day, okay, you need to give the status of all you have done to your manager or supervisor. Okay, if you are not working in organization, you can understand it like if a person is keeping a diary, it's record all the things in the diary. Okay. All the things, what went wrong, what is right, the sequence of steps that you have taken whole day. So all those things, it's kind of, so that is what is logging. So in terms of in SSIS or in SQL Server, we can say that thing is a logging. Now, what is the importance of logging? We'll understand. Usually SSIS package is deployed in a different environment like SIT environment, production environment, lower environment, in the SQL Server agent jobs. So all the SSIS package, once it is deployed, it is running under the SSI under the jobs. So suppose SSIS package is consist of many tasks. In reality, till now in my session, we have taken a very simple, we have created very simple packages where we have only one task. But in reality, we would have a number of tasks in the SSIS package. And if any one of the tasks got failed, so we need to know and what task has failed, what went wrong, at what step it got failed, okay, to further troubleshoot this thing. So if we are creating, if we are in development phase, like right, if you can see in my screen, okay. Here I have a project, I have a list of projects. So here if anything went wrong, we can jump to the execution result and we'll see what went wrong at what step. Okay, but once it is deployed and it is running under the jobs, so it is very difficult to understand at what steps it got failed. For that, we usually implement the logging. So that is the importance of logging. Now the question comes, what are the ways of implementing logging in SSIS package? So SSIS package, there are two ways. Okay, first is the SSIS itself gives a number of providers, log providers, which are giving, with the help of those you can implement the logging. Number second, if you do not comfortable with, if you are not feel good of using the providers, what SSIS package is providing to you, you can always create a custom logging with the help of execute SQL task. If you see here, so you can write your code in okay, and you can implement your custom logging as per your convenience. So first we'll understand what are the basic log providers, what SSIS itself has provided to us, with the help of which we can implement the logging. So very first, if you see, let's suppose I have not implemented logging here, and I have this project which is loading load tab delimited text file. It is going to load the text file, okay, and I'll show you the the source file. What is the source file of it? So tab delimited file. So this is a tab delimited file. I'm going, so this let me correct this. Let me correct this file. Okay, so this file, if you see ID, first name, last name and city, so this is the simple file. So I'm going to load the data which is available in this file to this table in the SQL Server table, and this is the table which is, you right now it is blank. If you see here, this is blank. So I'm going to execute this package and I'll show you. Right now I have not implemented logging, so if I click on start, so what will happen, all the records will be inserted right from the text file to the table. Okay, let's wait for a couple of seconds, we will get the results. Okay, green tick, that means it got executed. We'll go to the data flow and see, three rows got inserted into destination table. Let's go to the destination and check. execute this query. All the three records has been inserted. Now let me include some error, or we can say let me induce an error in the text file. So open this text file, and instead of, as we know that ID column is an integer, so let me change it and make it a character. Change the data type and save this file. Okay, go back to our package, and now let's try to execute it. This time we will get an error, and to troubleshoot it, what we can do? See, it got failed at the destination step. So right now we are in development phase. We know, okay, it got failed. Where I need to look? I need to go to the progress, and we will see. Okay, so it got failed. Okay, what is the error? If you see here, the column status return, the value could not be converted. Okay, because of, so if you wanted to see entire error, so what you can right click and copy message test, and open any notepad, and here you can paste it. Okay, and this way you can read the entire error message what you have got. Let me maximize. Yeah, this is the error because of the potential loss of data. Okay, so this way you can read your message, but what happened if it is deployed? Okay, by that time we will not be able to see. So for that we are going to implement the logging now. So let me stop the debugging. Let's go here and check our table first. So two rows got inserted. The third row, because you remember third row we have changed to test, so that is why it has not got inserted. Now the next is, we understand the importance, we understand what is logging. Now the point is how we implement. So right click, there is a grid area. So anywhere in the package, in the control flow, if you right click, there is a first option, logging. Click on logging. So logging editor will be open to you, and it gives you a number of options to implement the logging. So very first is you see here a warning to configure the unique logging option, enable the logging. So we need to click here, okay, to enable the package. Now we have number of logging entries here. Let me go ahead and delete first so that we can give you a fresh content. Let me delete all the logging. So if you see here, it is asking you add a new log and the log providers. So SSIS gives a number of 5 log providers. With the help of that, you can implement your logging. So we'll understand first all the providers one by one. First is SSIS log provider for SQL Server. So it is saying if you wanted to log, you can log to the SQL Server table. Okay, as per your convenience. So we have 5 log provider. It is something like you have a mobile provider, right? You have a service provider for your mobile. Like you can take the features, you can take the services of Vodafone. You can either take the services of Airtel. You can take the services of all other mobile, Reliance. Okay, so these are the services provider. Similarly, these are the log providers. So basically what it is logging for you. It is adding logs for you. Okay, likewise all the service provided, what they give that enable you to contact to your to communicate with over the phone. Okay, so that is the main feature. So SSIS log providers, we have the main feature is to keep logs. So one is SQL Server. Okay, you can keep your logs of this particular SSIS package into the SQL Server table. Second, SSIS log provider for text file. It will save your logs into the text file. SSIS log provider for XML, it will save your logs into the XML file. SSIS log provider for Windows event log. Okay, so this is something where you will keep your logs in the window events, okay, into the event viewer of the window. And this is nothing but a provider for the SQL Server profiler. So if you wanted to create a TRES file, you wanted to keep all your logs into the TRES file, and you wanted to open the TRES file with the help of SQL Server profiler, then you should go for this option. So what we will do in this session, we will cover all the log providers here. Okay, so sit back, relax, and we are going to continue with all the log providers with the same SSIS package, so that you can understand the differentiate between all the service log providers. So very first is, we'll choose this server. So very first option is, we are going to add our log for this SSIS package for in the SQL Server table. So that has been done. Now click on add. Okay, and before okay, let's click on add. So this log has been added. We need to enable this. Okay, click checkbox. Configuration says that you need to give the connection to the SQL server, to which SQL server you need to connect. I already have a connection here. This is my database. Okay, this is my server, and for this server I already have a connection which is there in the package, so that is why it is giving me option. So let me go ahead and choose this. Okay, and now if you see here, we have a detail option here. Okay, so what it is saying, click on detail and see there are number of events on which we can create a logs. So event is nothing but we can see event is we can say error event is saying that whenever any error occur in this SSIS package, then only add a log. Okay, on information event is saying that it gives the information about your package. Every time when package execute, it gives the information. So this is not an error, this is just give the information like who is the operator of SSIS package, at what time the package got executed. Okay, it got so all kind of the information it will log. On error is something whenever any log happen, then only it will log, it will add a log in your in your text file, in your XML file, in trace file, or in your SQL Server table, whatever SSIS log provider you have chosen. So for that, to make this session very simple and precise, usually we can select multiple events. Okay, but to make this session understand, and I do not want this session to be very complicated for you, so I'll select only on error because I know my SSIS package is going to throw an error. So on error I wanted to keep a log. Okay, so I'll select on error event, only one event I'll select. You can go ahead and choose multiple error events as well. Now there is an option here, if you see advance, so click on advanced. This will give you a number of fields. What fields do you want to have have in your file? Okay, so on error, basically this is by default, these are the fields like computer, on which computer this package has been executed, what operator it has used, source name, source, okay, all this message data type. If you wanted to add more columns, or if you wanted to see like databytes, I don't want to keep log because the size is also the constraint, right? So I don't want my files to be big enough with the databytes. I don't want to log the databytes. I don't want execution ID as well. Okay, I want the message text. Whenever error occur, I wanted to know what is the text. I wanted the source. I wanted the source name. Okay, source ID is also not required. Source name is fine. Operator, I wanted to know who has run this and on which computer it had run. So using this advanced feature, you can go ahead and change the fields as per your convenience. Okay, then click on OK and right click here, go to logging again and check whether everything is set up correct or not. So we have chosen SSIS log provider for SQL Server, we have configured it, we have enabled it, and we have gone, we have selected the on error event. So okay, everything is fine, click on close and execute this package. So let's see what will happen. All the logging of this package will be stored into the SSI into the SQL Server table. Okay, we'll see in which table it got executed, it got stored. So see, we got error. If progress bar, we see this is the error we are getting. So we are expecting the same error in our logging file, but we have done this in SQL Server. So we should have a SQL Server table where we can look it. So that table is existing to system table. If you see here, system DB, our database is system DB. May refresh it. So the table created is SSIS log table, and that table is nothing but a system table which is going to generate whenever any error event occur, and when the event occur, error event occur, then the okay, this table is not been created here, something is not correct. Let me go ahead, go to the control flow, let's check the logging once again. let me see. I don't want this to be. See, this is SQL Server configured. So this is the sample DB, and this is enabled. Fine, on error is tick. Advanced is tick. More time, let's check. So you need to be very careful to see whether it is ticked or not, okay? Let's try it again. And refresh the table, system tables. Okay, so we have double, we have checked. Now we are going to execute our package again. And let's see. So it got failed as expected. Okay, here we have the sys SSIS log table. So this table will automatically got created, okay, very first time when the log will be, and when there is a error occurred, and as we have we have added the log and trace on the we have chosen the on error event. So this table, so the data will be inserted into this SSIS log table. So if you go here and execute, you can see here the package is started. Okay, package is started and error on error event has been caught here. Okay, and everything is been written here. So on error, what will happen? What is the, so these are these columns what we have chosen. If you remember the fields in advanced feature, we have chosen the fields. So those fields are nothing but columns here in this table: operators, computer, source ID, execution ID, starting, start time, end time, and the message. So what, so in the same error, if you copy and you can paste it over here, you will get to know, okay, the same error is logged here. Okay. Okay, there was an error in destination. Copy here and you can see the same error has been logged here. This value could not be converted because of potential loss of data. The same error what we have seen earlier. See, the value could not be converted because of potential loss of data. So this way you can implement the logging using the SQL Server log provider. Okay, this is the very first type of the logging. So if you go ahead and check for the second type of logging, so we'll see how we can implement that. The second type is nothing but a SSIS log provider for text file. So here we need to add a text file where you wanted to keep the logs for this particular package. So we will have the same on error event selected. Okay, so click on add. So it will add a text file, and this time we wanted the SSIS log to be added in the text file. So I have disabled the SQL Server and enabled this text file. Okay, what it is saying, it writes the log entry for the event to, it is saying event, so we can choose the multiple events, but for our case we have chosen one. Okay, on error, so write log entry for event on a CSV file. So we need to give the path of the CSV file where you wanted to write. Okay, if you have a file existing, you can choose that. If you do not have, you need to always have an option to create a file. So select the create file, browse the location where you wanted to keep your log file. So let me say I wanted to create a file here with a name like SSIS log error, let's say error logs. Okay, and I wanted, it's a text file. Click on OK, click on OK, and here we go, it is done. Okay, click on OK. So if you see, this connection is also been established here. So you do not need to do anything now, only the connection is, you need to give the location of the text file where you wanted to keep logs, and that's it. Now execute your package and see the effect whether the log is been added into this file or not. So first of all, it will go ahead and create a file. That file is not there just earlier, so we'll go to that location and see this file has been created and it is of 10 KB. That means something has written over here. So let me open this file. Okay, you see the entire data has been logged here. Package start, laptop name, everything, package number, description, all on error. So if you see, the on error event has been thrown here. Okay, this is package start, packet end, and before in between we have this many of on error events. And what is the error? If you go ahead and check here, see the value cannot be converted because of the potential loss of data. So this way you can implement the logging to this text file. Now go ahead back and stop the debugging. Now we'll check the third type of the logging. Right click, open the log editors. And the third one is SQL Server. We have covered text file. Third is XML. So here we need to add our logs to the XML file. So similarly, it has also the similarly the same thing. We need to add an XML file. And this is if you extend, you can see this says log provider for XML. And what it does, it will add write a log entry for the events to the XML file. So we need to give the location of the XML file. We do not have XML file as of now, so create a new location. I do not have an existing file. I wanted to create a file, so I choose the create file. So which location do you want? I need the same location with the same name, only the extension would be different. Okay, XML. So this file would be an XML file. I wanted to keep my logs for this package into the XML file. Let me go ahead and execute this package. This package will throw an error, and on error event will occur. And when this event will occur, the logging will be happened, and it will create a package. It will create an XML file here. So if you go ahead and you can open with Internet Explorer, you can open with an Internet Explorer, you can open with a Visual Studio, any platform you can open it. So I'll choose the Internet Explorer. See, next, ask me later. So if you see, the event is, the very first event is the package start. The package start and package stop end is the by default event. It will be, you know, it will occur in every of the logging. So the event we have chosen is on error. So on error is this. This is the message, if you see. Okay, all everything is there. All the error has been there. Okay, so this way you can implement the logging in XML file. Now go ahead and check for the fourth one, which is open the log editor, and the fourth one is the Windows event log. So choose this, disable this, and add the window logs. So if you see, there is no configuration for the window. Let me enable this first. And what is the name of it? Let's check. It says log provider for Windows event log. And what is the description? It says it logs an entry for the event into the event log. And there is no configuration here because the window event log is the part of the window of your system. Okay, how you can open it? You just type in the start. You just type event and event viewer. Okay, and you will get an option. Just in case if you are not getting option, you can go to the control panel, click on the administrative tool, and there, from there you will find an event event logs, event viewer. You can find this option and you can open from there also. So for me, it is already opened. Okay, so I'll run as administrator. Let me open this. So what will happen, this, if I choose this log provider, all the log entries would be inserted into my Windows log event viewer. Here in event viewer we can log the entries in custom views in window. So for us, we have a Windows logs, and under the application it would be inserted here. Now we'll go back here, first configure this. So we have just need to enable this, nothing else. We do not need to provide the location because already in the Windows. So click on OK. Let's go ahead and start it, and we'll see the log entry will be inserted into window event logs or not. So let it, okay, it got this failed, which is fine. Okay, we have already opened here. If you see here in Windows log application, see on error and SSIS. The source would be the SSIS package, okay? Because we wanted the we have implemented logging in SSIS package because this is something which is for all kind of the application, all kind of the background things that is going on that we it is giving logging. So all kind of the sources are there, like HP communication recovery, all other things. See, I have connected to the SQL server. So this is my instance name. So the information is been logged here. Okay, so SSIS package, the information on an event has been triggered here and the information has been captured here. Okay, this way you can find the information. So the very last but not the least, which is very important, some people wanted to always prefer this option to enable the logging at the SQL profiler level, which is the fifth one. Okay, so that is, let me choose this SSIS log provider for the SQL server profiler. So click here, click on add. So this is the last one. What it will do, it will create the logging into your TRES file. TRES file is something which keeps the tracking of all the things, and we will be open, and how we can open the TRES file with the help of SQL Server Profiler. So what is the SQL Server Profiler? That is the functionality which is given into the SQL Server. I'll tell you. So let me click here. Okay. Configuration, we needed to click create a new connection because we do not have a TRES file. We wanted to create, as we have created a text file, as we have created an XML file, we need to create a TRES file. So create a file and browse in the same location we are going to, with the same name, SSIS error logs.trc. So the trc is the file name extension, file extension for TRES file. Click on OK, and here we go. So it is done. So let me execute this package, and we'll see the data has been inserted into the TRES file or not. So it got failed, which is fine, which is expected. And if you see, okay, file is not been created here, or might be I have given some other location. Let me go ahead and check first. So for that, we need to stop the debugging first. Go ahead and logging. Open it, SSIS log.xml. Okay, what I have done? Okay, sorry. So this one is enabled, SSIS error logs.trc. Okay, and if you go here, this is a connection manager. Just see SSIS error logs.trc. Okay, go ahead, and this is not available here, so I need to click on view and open everything. We need to hidden items, we need to see. MS prep, and it should be created here only. Let me see. Okay, so we have implemented the tracing. We have implemented the configuration for the tracing file to be created. If you see, we have chosen this as SQL Server Profiler here, and the configuration is package1.trc. Okay, and we have done it for both package level and the data task level. Okay, and this is there. Click on OK. The connection manager is. New connection is been created. I have changed the folder here, and I have created new folder log in the desktop, and there I have created package1.trc. So what will happen whenever any information, this package got executed, okay, and I have selected the on information event instead of on error event, so that at least we will get some information data. Okay, so I'm going to execute this package here. Okay, it will be executed successfully. Okay, and now I'll go to the desktop, and here in the log file there is a folder log which we have created, and here I'm supposed to get the package1.trc file, but some reason I guess it is not been created. So for that we need to check the feasibility in SSIS package, whether it allowed to create a TRES file or not. So that we need to cover in the next session. It is entirely another topic, so it will take much time to cover in the session. So for in your case, if it is already built in your SSIS package and it allow you to create a TRES file, then the TRES file will be created in your location. And once that file with an extension .trc has been created, how you can read it? Open the SSIMS here and go to the tools, click on the SQL Server Profiler. With the help of SQL Server Profiler, you can you will be able to open your trust file, because in my case trust file is not being generated, so I'll not be able to open that, but I'll show you how you can open your trust file here. So connect the profiler first. So we have connected the profiler. So here by default you it is giving you an option to create a trust file from the SQL server. So I don't want, we here we do not need to create a trust file from the SQL server. So close this dialog box, okay, and go to the file and click on open and choose the option trust file. Here you will locate your trust file, okay, in the in desktop, in log, I should have this trust file. So you can choose this trust file and open it. So once you open the trust file, you will all get all the details like on error event, what you have in on information event, everything what you have in the text file, and similarly you will get all the information for the trust file in the SQL Server profiler. Okay, so this way, as we have learned in this session, that how we can implement the logging by using all the service all five type of the log providers which is provided by the SSIS, how we can implement the logging in SQL Server, okay, how we can write the logs in the text file, write the logs in the XML file, write the logs in event, and how we can write the logs in the trust file, and we can read the trust file using the SQL Server profiler. Unfortunately, in this session this has not happened, but I will cover it in the next session. So okay, so I think you get an idea how we can implement the logging and why it is important in SSIS package. So I think you like the video, and just in case if you have any question and doubt, please comment me in the text. I'll be more happy to give you answer. Thank you.